Today, we're going to talk about LoRA training for Qwen Image. Of course, a LoRA itself isn't particularly special. We commonly see six types of LoRA. First, style. Second, concept. Third, character. Fourth, object. Fifth, clothing. And sixth, pose. Today, what we're going to train is a character, LoRA, specifically a girl with long hair, glasses, and a high ponytail. This is my training data. Take a look. When building the entire dataset, we tried our best to ensure the consistency of the character. Therefore, different LoRAs have different characteristics, which are mainly reflected in the base model. What are the features of the Qwen Image model? We've already demonstrated them when discussing this model. It has powerful composition ability, or rather, composition control ability. Moreover, it has very exquisite text display capability, allowing it to accurately render various types of text. Therefore, Qwen Image's LoRA will also possess these same capabilities. For instance, take a look. This is the character LoRA I trained, and I can very easily use it to generate an image like this. Then, I can use Qwen Image Edit to modify and generate images in the same scene, but with different perspectives and varying levels of detail. From there, I can generate a video like this. Take a look at the overall video effect. Isn't it also very beautiful? Furthermore, Qwen Image's LoRA has an unparalleled advantage that other models cannot match. That is, it can be used not only with the Qwen Image model, but also with the Qwen Image Edit picture editing model. Here, I'll give you a simple demonstration. This is a Qwen Image Edit workflow. Here, I've loaded the model I just trained, and I have a reference image, which is a blue and white porcelain bowl. Then, in the prompt, I used the trigger words for my LoRA. That, I wrote, an exquisite face, followed by a woman holding a blue and white porcelain bowl. And then I got an image like this. Take a look. The effect of this LoRA is very clear. It can be used with Qwen Image Edit. This makes handling character consistency much simpler when creating many video scenes. The tool we are using is musubi-tuner. What you are seeing now is the tools page on GitHub. In previous tutorials, we actually used tools. One is called musubi-tuner, and the other is called AI Toolkit. Both have their pros and cons. The advantage of AI Toolkit is its ease of use, while musubi-tuner's advantage is that it uses fewer resources. Next, I'll demonstrate, step by step, how to train a Qwen Image LoRA. I've deployed the entire musubi-tuner into the workspace. Let's take a look. This is the repository we cloned. This is the entire repository. Inside, I've written some documentation for everyone. First, under the dataset folder, we can find it in the file browser on the left. There's a notebook here. You can open it. It contains detailed operating instructions. You can refer to this document to perform Qwen Image LoRA training. There are a few directories here that I created. Dataset is where we put our datasets. Models is for downloading models, and output is for storing our trained models. Before we actually start training, let me talk about dataset construction. Regarding dataset construction, I'd like to introduce a secret, or a method, for generating a virtual character, LoRA. I simply call it, Find His Sister. Note that this isn't an insult. It literally means, Find His Sister. I found a very beautiful image of a woman on Twitter, but if I were to use it directly, there might be copyright issues. So, I used the excellent Nano Banana model to generate a picture of this girl's sister. My prompt was written like this. Generate a picture of this girl's sister, as beautiful as possible, with a high ponytail, black-rimmed glasses, and sportswear. But I thought her hairstyle wasn't very good. So, I tried to make some changes to her hairstyle. I wrote the following prompt. Use this image to create a 3x3 image matrix, with each image featuring a different hairstyle. And I got a result like this. Take a look. Then, I picked my favorite, which was the middle one. I extracted it and used Nano Banana to upscale and repair it, resulting in my first photo. Then, I further used Nano Banana to generate its left view, rear view, and right view. I also used different prompts to generate photos in various environments. Take a look. Each one is quite different. So, this is the training dataset you ultimately see. Therefore, although we refer to Qwen Image, we have to admit that Nano Banana's capabilities are indeed very powerful. After the dataset is built, I will upload it to the dataset directory. Inside, there's a folder called Train, which is for training. This folder will contain our images and our prompts. We need to write a data configuration file like this. Let's open it. Note that the file extension is TOML. It's a markup language, and its format is fixed. There are two main sections here. The first is general, which covers conventional settings. We need to specify the resolution. Mine is all 1024. Then there's the caption extension, which is the file extension for your prompt files. Ours is singlequotes.txt. Set the batch size to 1, and the other two can remain at their default values. The dataset section mainly sets two directories. One is our dataset directory, which for me is currently in the train folder under dataset. And then there's our cache directory. We'll discuss the purpose of the cache directory later. I've also placed this file under dataset. Next, let's look at model downloading. On musubi-tuner's official website, there's also a guide for Qwen image training. Actually, the information there might be a bit disorganized. Regarding model downloading, please note that our main model and our text encoder can both be downloaded from Qwen's official website. However, the VAE is an exception. The VAE must be downloaded from Qwen Image's official website. The V within Qwen cannot be used. I also have the specific download links here. After downloading, we'll proceed to generate cache files. As we know, images need to be encoded into the latent space, primarily using the V model. So, this command can pre-encode our images, meaning they won't need to be encoded again during training. Let's copy this command, then go into our command line. Pay attention. Your current directory must be under the musubi-tuner directory. Then we paste it and press enter. Please note that for each image, we've generated a corresponding safe tensors file. Next, we'll also pre-encode the prompts. So, we'll use this command. In this command, we again specify the data configuration file. That is, the location of the TOML file we just mentioned. And here, we need to specify the directory where our text encoder is located. Then we copy it, and again, press enter. This has also completed execution. We can see that there's a corresponding safe tensors file here after the prompt conversion. Next, we'll start our training. Let me briefly explain the training command. First, it involves our CPU, specifically, the number of threads it needs to process. Below that is the precision of our model. Here, we're using BF16. Further down is the script used, which is fixed. Next, we specify where the main model is, where the VAE is, and where our text encoder is. Here, we specify where the dataset is located. The dataset's position is also determined by the TOML file we just mentioned. This specifies the location of our dataset and our cache. Then, there's the type of attention weight we use. If you have other attention mechanisms installed, like flash attention or sage attention, you can use them. However, sage attention can only be used during inference. So, to be safe, you can just use SDPA. As for the trained precision, I'm using FP8 base here, and it's crucial to clearly state here that I am currently training a Qwen image LoRA. The dim value of the trained LoRA, which is its rank value, is 16, and I'm training for 300 epochs. Please note, these are not steps. We've mentioned this multiple times before. Then, I save the model every 25 epochs. For the seed value, we generally use 42, right? And where do I save my model? I save it in the output folder. Its name is this. Then, I'm using block swap. If you don't enable block swap, your 24GB VRAM won't be enough. Now, let's execute it. Ctrl plus C2 copy, then go into our command line. Remember, your root directory must be under musubi-tuner. Then, Ctrl-V, and enter. Soon, you'll enter the main model loading stage. Let's wait a moment. As you can see, it's now loaded. Now, it needs to convert the main model's data format to FP8, and then it will start training. This is the first epoch out of 300. Since there are 16 images, each needs 300 epochs of computation, making it 4,800 steps. Okay, the progress bar has now appeared. We won't continue the training from this point. You just need to wait for the final result to come out. After the training is complete, we can then test this LoRA. We'll load this LoRA into our standard Qwen image workflow. Then, I wrote a very complex prompt describing a fashionable girl leaning against a tech sculpture. The text is Veteran AI. That's the name of my English channel on YouTube, so feel free to check it out if you're interested. Let's run it and see the generated effect. I won't explain the workflow since it's a standard Qwen workflow. Take a look. The character's form, my text description, and the overall composition are all excellent. So, our training should be fine. Of course, you can't conclude anything from just one image. You'll need to conduct extensive testing. Finally, let's talk about installing musubi-tuner. Its installation is actually very simple. You just need to follow its installation steps. Let me give you a quick demonstration now. Before installation, you need to confirm your basic environment. First, we use nvcc-5 to check my CUDA version. Mine is 12.6. My Python version is 3.10. Then, I check my PyTorch version, which is 2.6. It requires a version greater than 2.5.1, so this meets the requirement. Then, I clone the entire repository. We navigate into this directory and then execute pip install e, and that's all. Then, we'll see it start installing all the dependency packages. Once this is completed, our basic environment will be considered installed. As I mentioned earlier, this Qwen Image LoRA can be used not only with the Qwen Image model, but also with Qwen Image Edit. I've just shown you this example. Here's a bowl, and using my LoRA, you'll find that this character is very similar to the one I trained with LoRA. This is a very important point. If you use it well, it will make a lot of your work much simpler. All right, that concludes our discussion on Qwen Image LoRA training. What are you waiting for? Go try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.